Hello, my name is Shantanu Banerjee. I am a trainer from Trends IT. My training areas include Oracle WebLogic Administration, Development and Designing, Oracle SOA Training, Administration, Spring, Hibernate, Java, J2E technologies. And I have the experience of handling clients like Infosys, Wipro, Capgemini, Verizon, GE, and few more. And generally, I believe on hands-on, so my trainings would include most of the times hands-on, and every little lecture will follow a hands-on, and hands-on will be covering almost 60-70% of the curriculum. Welcome to my class of WebLogic Administration. Today, I'm going to demonstrate how to create a data source connection pool, target it to an application server, and modify its connection pool properties. As you can see, we are already inside the administration console of WebLogic server. On the domain structure window, left side, click on Services, Data Sources. Once you click to Data Sources, press on Lock and Edit. Now, click on New, Generic Data Source. In this page, you have to provide the database data source details here. So, let us keep it as Demo DS and provide a JNDI name as JDBC/DemoDS. Then select the database. Oracle WebLogic Server supports plenty of databases, as you can see here. We will select Oracle and then press Next. The next page, you need to select the driver. Now, we are going to select Oracle's thin driver for instance connection for a normal data source and press Next. Here, accept the details, whatever is by default selected, then press Next. This page, you need to provide the connection details of the database. And remember, before you come to this page, your backend database must be running. We provide, in my case, I am using an SID or database name as XE. My host is localhost, port is the default port 1521. I am using a username as system password. After you fill in this page, press Next. This page summarizes the details of connection properties. There is a button here. Before you go further, you must test the configuration. So press test configuration. It must return successful. As you can see, this test has succeeded already. So now we can press Next and select the server where you are going to target it. So select admin server and then finish. The data source is now targeted to admin server. Click on activate changes, which will make the changes permanent. Press activate changes. The data source is targeted to administration server.